You took photos of planes, Sofia?
Yes, but it's the white trails that interest me.
And, what are those trails exactly?
Apparently, they're not great for the planet.
We'd be better going outside to talk about it. Come on, guys.
Do you reckon trails could make a nice drawing, like a heart-shaped cloud? It's for my new girlfriend. She's super romantic.
Sure, Sam. Like pilots have time for that.
Some say there are chemicals in them.
No, they're condensation trails, or contrails, so mostly ice crystals.
So, basically water. Engines release particles and water vapor. Under certain atmospheric conditions, water vapor condenses onto particles, forming droplets. And since it's very cold at that altitude, the droplets freeze and become ice crystals. That's the same principle behind high-altitude clouds.
But why are there more of them some days than others?
Contrails only form in parts of the atmosphere where the humidity and temperature allow ice crystals to develop. And, as atmospheric conditions change constantly, the same airplane can fly through the same spot at two different times and can either make contrails or not.
Without certain conditions, they disappear almost as fast as they appear.
Okay, but if you're saying it's just water, then what's the big deal?
Well, you see, Jade, contrails create a sort of veil. In the daytime, they can block the sun like a parasol. But when they form late in the day or at night, they don't dissipate quickly. They act like a blanket, trapping heat and preventing the Earth from cooling naturally.
Okay, got it. So they contribute to global warming.
Oh, I had no idea. And isn't there anything we can do?
Well, first, we have to identify what's responsible for these trails. On a global scale, calculations have shown that in 2023, 3% of flights generated 80% of global warming from persistent contrails.
Airlines could adapt their flight plans according to the weather. Like, by changing altitude or by taking a slight detour.
But, Bess, if they take a detour, planes will burn more fuel.
And emit more CO2.
Yeah, and on top of that, it could disrupt air traffic by delaying other takeoffs and landings.
And so maybe more CO2 emissions.
The truth is, there's still a lot to learn about contrails, particularly in measuring their impact on global warming and the exact mechanism behind their formation.
In fact, Safran's working with climate scientists and atmosphere experts to understand the phenomenon better. And Safran has been investing in a startup which analyzes flight data to help airlines and airports minimize their emissions.
And sustainable fuels? SAF? They could help, maybe?
True. SAF may generate fewer particles. And fewer particles usually means fewer contrails, so it's definitely a step in the right direction.
Beyond SAF, Safran and partners are working on engines that emit fewer and fewer particles, helping to cut condensation.
So, let me get this straight. By adjusting air traffic, by using SAF, and with better engines, we're on the right track then.
Okay, that's cool for the planet, but no cute little heart-shaped cloud for my girlfriend anytime soon.